Cantor Audio, a division of Recorded Books, presents Lose Your Final 15, Dr. Rowe's plan to eat 15 servings a day and lose 15 pounds at a time, by Rovenia M. Brock, PhD. Narrated by Rovenia M. Brock, PhD. Publisher's note: this audiobook is packaged with bonus material, which has been included on the first audio and MP3 CD. If you downloaded this audiobook in a digital format, please visit tantor.com and type Lose Your Final 15 into the search box. Follow the link to the book's page, then click on PDF Extra 1. When prompted, enter the access code SERVINGS to access the bonus material. For Lavinia L. Brock and Rosetta Hyman Lewis, who taught me by example that love is the single most emotion to sustain humankind. For my husband, Murray, who has loved me with an open heart unconditionally, without fail, for 15 years. For Della Bannister, a legend among nutrition professionals, who modeled excellence professionally and personally, and who saw in me a yearning to use what she taught me to be of service to others. You have a permanent place in my heart. Rest in peace. For Simba, my companion and our family in Cocker Spaniel form, a warrior who sees the good in all and who never gives up, even when others doubt what you're made of. You inspire me. For the scores of you who struggle with weight issues and who search for solutions, may you know kindness in the face of judgment, love in the face of disdain, and progress over perfection always. It is my sincere hope that this work helps you to get closer to the life you envision. Together, we can do this. Introduction. Although I didn't realize it at the time, I started writing this book when I was 9 years old. My mother, Lavinia Brock, had been diagnosed with stomach cancer the year I was born. She had fought it off for years, but by the time I was 9, she was dying. She made many visits to the hospital in Washington, D.C. that year, and I often went with her. While she met with her doctors, I spent time with her friend, Ruby Kavanaugh, one of the hospital's dietitians. Mrs. Kavanaugh taught patients how to improve their health by changing their diets. She educated people with ailments such as heart disease, diabetes, kidney disease, and cancer about how their dietary choices could help them or hurt them. As a child, I had only a vague understanding of Mrs. Kavanaugh's work with sick patients, and I certainly didn't comprehend the complex relationship between diet and health. But looking back, I realized that during those visits with Mrs. Kavanaugh, I began connecting some very important dots, and I started to hear the faint whisper of my life's calling. My family ate a traditional Southern diet. We feasted regularly on deep-fried chicken, pork chops smothered in rich gravy, country ham, fried salt fish, hoe cake, scrapple, chitlins, greens seasoned with fatback, potato salad smothered in mayonnaise, and a cornucopia of other dishes laden with fat, salt, and sugar. These foods brought us together. Made from recipes passed down for generations, they represented our Southern culture and our family heritage. Just as these Southern dishes were a part of the fabric of my childhood, so too was the presence of disease and disability. My grandparents, uncles, and aunts experienced a long list of health problems, including diabetes, hypertension, stroke, glaucoma, various kinds of cancer, and peripheral vascular disease, which my family called poor circulation. Many of my relatives, neighbors, and family friends were overweight or obese. Looking back, it should have come as no surprise to me on the playground the day that a friend announced, My daddy had to have his legs cut off because of diabetes. Eventually, three of my maternal uncles would require limb amputations because of complications from peripheral vascular disease. At the age of 9, I started to understand in a rudimentary way that my community's eating habits were killing them. That connection stayed with me during adolescence, and when it came time for me to decide what to study in college at Virginia State University, I chose nutrition. In college, I learned the many ways in which food influences our health. I realized that my mother's diet and weight almost certainly contributed to her stomach cancer and her early death. I discovered why my uncles lost limbs to diabetes and peripheral vascular disease. And with a very heavy heart, I came to understand how much suffering and death in my family and my community could have been postponed or prevented if someone had taught the people I loved how to eat a healthier diet. Without hesitation, I embraced the role of nutrition educator. I followed in Mrs. Kavanaugh's footsteps, working in hospitals and nursing homes, educating patients with heart disease and diabetes on ways to improve their health by managing their diets. At the University of Maryland Medical System in Baltimore, I taught patients how to live and thrive after having coronary artery bypass surgery. Later, I worked in the renal and critical care units at Howard University Hospital. Ironically, the same hospital where I sat with Mrs. Kavanaugh all those years earlier. Using my nutrition skills and knowledge to improve the quality of patients' lives. Working with patients was hugely satisfying for me. So many of my patients reminded me of my family and the wonderful warm people in the LeDroit Park community in which I had grown up. I felt that by helping them, I was honoring my mother and all of the other people I loved whose health had been destroyed by poor diets and excess weight. But I wanted to do more. I wanted to be able to help more people than just the patients who came through my hospital. I realized that the best way to reach large numbers of people about the connections between diet and health was to take to the airways. So I went back to school and earned a master's degree in community nutrition and broadcast journalism, and then a doctoral degree in nutritional sciences from Howard University. Since then, I've made it my mission to reach out to as many people as possible through the media. I have hosted local and national radio and television shows. I've written extensively about nutrition and weight loss and the impact of both on health and quality of life. I've also written about how to break bad health habits, especially those considered to sabotage lasting weight loss success. On the Dr. Oz Show, I created a program that guided over 500,000 Americans to lose more than 5 million collective pounds. Through my 28 years as a practicing nutritionist, it had become crystal clear to me that diet and exercise are the foundation of a healthy lifestyle. About 80% of the weight loss process is due to diet, but 20% has everything to do with physical activity. The two go hand in hand. For my entire career, I've made it my mission to learn everything there is to know about healthy living so I could pass it on to you and to all of the other people who need help making choices about diet and fitness. Although I have a PhD in nutrition, not all of my knowledge comes from textbooks. Despite everything I know about food, exercise, and health, the truth is, I've had my own struggles with diet and weight. Up until my mid-20s, I was quite thin, weighing in at about 100 pounds. But like a lot of Black women, I worried that men wouldn't find me attractive unless I put a little more meat on my bones. This is a message that many women of color continue to hear now. I believe it is one of the reasons that obesity is a bigger problem in the African American and Latino communities than it is among other races. I can't believe it when I look back at those years, but I won't lie to you. I actually started overeating on a regular basis in order to appear more desirable to men, gobbling up steak and cheese subs, ice cream, and an embarrassing array of junk food. I piled on 30 pounds. Friends and relatives congratulated me on my curves. Eventually, when I was in my 30s, I took a look at myself and realized how foolish I'd been to gain all that extra weight. During the years that followed, I lost it and gained it back a few times, yo-yoing back and forth until I finally figured out how to follow my own advice and keep the weight off for good through diet and exercise. All of this has led me to where I am right now. The book in your hands is the culmination of my decades of experience as a nutrition educator, a woman who has struggled with her own weight, and the child of a family and a community that has suffered the devastating effects of poor diet and excess weight. This book, which can trace its history back to the broken heart of a 9-year-old girl in Washington, D.C., brings together the knowledge, advice, and inspiration that made it possible for me to help thousands and thousands of people, and myself, lose weight and regain health by making life-saving diet changes. This is the book that I wish my mother could have read before being taken from me, or that my uncles could have read before having their limbs amputated, or that my beautiful guardian, Rosetta Lewis, who raised me, could have read before experiencing heart disease, high blood pressure, and breast cancer. It is a book that I want you and every other one of God's children to read and use so that you can start making choices that will give you a long, healthy, happy life. In this book, you will see that I have developed a program composed of 3 phases, 15 days each, on which you will eat 15 servings of delicious, nutritious, metabolism-boosting foods daily to help you lose weight. The first phase is probably the most difficult, but trust me, it is the most effective and quickest way to see the results of getting to your goal weight. And it may sound like it would be hard to do, but don't balk at the idea of eating 15 servings of food a day, because it's easier than you think. It is doable, simple, and sensible. I'm not asking you to eat 15 times a day, but rather to eat the correct portions of foods you're used to eating every day. What's different is that I have developed a plan with built-in macronutrients and calories ranging from 1,200 to 1,400 that you don't have to count. So the amount of servings you'll be eating will help you to shed unwanted pounds. What's more, after eating this way, you will be equipped with the tools needed to eat anywhere, whether it's at home or away. And you will gain the necessary knowledge to eyeball correct food portions, which prevents overeating and helps you to stick to your prescribed calorie budget. About the book. Weight loss, diet change, and fitness can be overwhelming. This is especially true if you're facing a mountain-sized goal. If you've got a lot of pounds to lose, or your diet is nothing but junk food, or you haven't exercised in a very long time, or ever. I get it. This stuff is hard. If it were easy, you wouldn't need a book like this. But here's the thing. If you break one big goal into lots of smaller goals, you're much more likely to succeed and far less likely to feel overwhelmed. That's the philosophy behind my Final 15 F15 plan. Based on the work I've done with thousands of patients, I've discovered that breaking everything up into units of 15 makes insurmountable challenges much easier to accomplish. I call this the rule of 15. And it's the backbone of all of the recommendations that I make in this book. The F15 plan is an easy-to-follow diet and exercise plan that works with your body type, whether you tend to gain weight all over your body, just in the belly area or in the hips and thighs, or, dare I say, gulp, booty. For each body type, I provide a different strategy to help you lose all of your excess weight, including your final 15 pounds. Less body fat, more energy. Using the F15 plan, you'll permanently lose belly fat, a problem that women and men alike confront day after day. You'll feel energized because the plan helps you to choose foods that are best for your body. You'll also learn to detect and avoid food sensitivities that may be causing you to hold on to excess weight and that zap your energy as well. The F15 plan is simple and will fit any lifestyle, whether you're a student or a truck driver, an office worker or a store clerk, a desk-bound engineer or an always-on-your-feet choir director, a teacher or a firefighter, or anything else in between. This is the plan for you. How can a healthy eating plan fit such a wide range of needs for such a diverse audience? By taking into account the need we all have for peak performance and energy. We are busy. We have families to raise, jobs to do, responsibilities to shoulder. So we all need an eating and exercise plan that can fit into the never-ending demands in our lives. I kept all that in mind when I created the F15 plan. To help you in your quest to be your best you, I have developed a diet that will not only help you lose weight, but also help you breeze through plateaus and keep it off, all 15 pounds at a time. The F15 plan is about permanent weight loss. There are no tricks or gimmicks, just a realistic plan that you can use to lose weight, lower your risk of disease, and live with for the rest of your life. Here's how it works. An easy, sensible food plan. The F15 eating plan consists of three 15-day phases. In each phase, you get to enjoy 15 servings of food per day, tracking servings rather than calories, fat grams, exchanges, or other units, is an easy, realistic way to eat the right amount of food for successful weight loss. And when you move to maintenance mode, you'll be glad that you kept track of realistic food servings and portions that you can use everywhere you go, both at home and away. In phase one, you will eat power-packed foods, including vegetables and lean proteins. This helps you to kickstart weight loss and get your body to a clean and lean state. In phase two, you will eat often and early so you can rev up your metabolism and prevent overeating. Foods in this phase include the same tasty high-protein choices found in phase one, including eggs, low-fat dairy, vegetables, beans, seeds, and legumes, with an addition of fruit. In phase three, you will be able to add in sprouted high-protein whole grains. This phase focuses on eating a variety of whole foods to keep yourself full for longer periods of time without overeating. In each phase, you'll learn to identify the best foods for your lifestyle and body type, as well as the triggers that derail your progress. And you'll eat tasty, easy-to-prepare foods that give you more energy, shrink belly fat, and improve your overall health and longevity. Quick, simple, and delicious recipes. In the F15 plan, I've included tasty, delicious recipes for each phase, which gives you everything you need to be successful. Most of these recipes can be prepared in 15 minutes or less. These easy-to-make recipes will fit perfectly into your meal plan and your busy schedule. I know how important that is. I've coached clients for nearly 3 decades, and I'm no fool. I understand that you live in a time-starved world, and that you have to make the most of your limited time while continuing to run here and there as you parent, answer the demands of your job, and try to look and feel your best at the same time. It's a daunting process, but with the F-15 plan, you can beat the defeat you may have experienced in the past and lose weight for good this time. Fabulous no-fail fitness routines. The recommended goal for exercise is at least 30 minutes a day. Most days of the week, and more if you really want to rev up exercise. But if you aren't already in an exercise habit, the thought of working out 30-plus minutes daily can be hugely overwhelming. That's why, as with everything else in my F-15 plan, we'll start with 15-minute workout chunks. This allows you to start with one exercise unit per day, establish an exercise habit, and then go up from there. My no-fail exercise plan includes belly banishing, strength training exercises that feel less like work and more like a fresh new way of life. Even for those of you whose only exercise has been running late and jumping to conclusions. Steady, permanent weight loss. My clients find that losing weight 15 pounds at a time is doable and lasting, regardless of the number of pounds they have to lose. If you have, say, 45 pounds to lose, it's much easier to think of losing 15 pounds three times than to worry about losing an entire 45 pounds at once. You'll start by focusing on the first 15. Then, once you meet that goal, you can think about the next 15. Science has shown us that people enjoy greater success by tackling their weight loss problems in small increments. Most of my clients find that losing weight this way gets them consistent, lasting results. It works for them, regardless of the number of pounds they have to lose, whether it's 15 pounds or 115 pounds. What's more, they are far more likely to stay the course when they see the results. The good news is that losing just 15 pounds can have an amazing impact on your health, no matter what size you are. Research shows that overweight or obese people who lose as little as 5 to 10% of their weight start seeing dramatic reductions in medical risks. For example, diabetes risk drops significantly with a loss of just 5 to 10% of your body weight. For someone who weighs 200 pounds, that's a weight loss of 10 to 20 pounds, which really is a very attainable goal. Losing that first 15 pounds may not get you back into the jeans you wore in high school, but it can lower your risk of heart disease and diabetes, improve your blood sugar, increase your sensitivity to insulin, lower your blood pressure, and decrease inflammation. Furthermore, once you lose the first 15 pounds, you've proven to yourself that you have the power to do it over again and again if you need to. Important new eating behaviors. Success isn't just about eating the right foods. It's about changing the way you think about food. That's why the F-15 plan focuses on changing your eating habits as well as the foods you choose. I'll show you how to redirect emotional eating and how to pinpoint the factors that push you off course. And I'll help you discover how to curb cravings and halt stress eating for good. You'll also master the art, yes, it's an artful process, of avoiding late-night snacking, one of the biggest roadblocks to weight loss success. And you will be empowered to forge ahead without self-doubt and deprecation. As your coach, I will hold your hand and have your back to get you through the entire process. Inspiration that goes deep. Losing weight requires motivation and inspiration. Most people who lose weight and keep it off do so not simply because they have a surplus of willpower, but because they are motivated to do so. They win at the weight loss game because motivation and encouragement work, especially when willpower is in short supply. Using techniques that work for my clients, I will share motivational and inspirational tools and tips throughout the book to help you stick to the process during moments of weakness. As you work toward becoming self-motivated, I want you to remember that I'll be with you, guiding you every step of the way throughout your weight loss program. The whole F15 package. Imagine enjoying 15 servings a day of the tastiest, easiest to prepare, most power-packed foods you'll ever eat. Visualize yourself exercising in 15-minute chunks, doing muscle-building moves that give you energy, build strength, and rev up your metabolism. Envision taking 15 minutes of your day to nourish and refresh your mind and to feed your soul, letting go of stresses of the day. That, in a nutshell, is the F15 plan. Sure, you may have tried to lose weight before, but you threw in the towel because the foods didn't suit you, or you pushed yourself to do too much exercise, or you were so focused on achieving weight loss that you forgot to give yourself time to relax and restore. That won't happen with the F15 plan, because it is tailored to your specific needs, lifestyle, likes, and dislikes. What's not to like about that? Plus, the F15 plan is easy because I've done most of the work for you. Not only does it include meal plans and recipes, but I've given you shopping lists as well. I encourage you to continue on to find real foods and easy-to-do moves that you can incorporate into your daily life as it is now. That's right. I'm not asking you to become someone else in order to reach your goal. You are already the superstar of your own life. So why not live it to the fullest in your best body? You can and will do this because the individualized meal plan made just for you, not the entire universe, as if that would work, will be tailored to your needs with the foods you enjoy. You don't even have to give up dessert. Remember, I helped more than 500,000 Americans lose over 5 million pounds with a similar version of the F15 plan on the Dr. Oz show. I can help you too. Now, all I need is your buy-in and willingness to love yourself enough to give you a try for a really great outcome. So say it with me. I can do this. Louder, like you're for real. Say it. I can do this. Now take a deep breath. Let's get started. Part 1, Getting Started. Chapter 1, What is the F15 Philosophy? Nothing tastes as good as weight loss feels, Dr. Rowe. Okay, raise your hand if you feel like a failure. Your hand went up, didn't it? I know it did. And if it didn't, it's probably because you're not being completely honest with yourself. How do I know you feel like a failure? Because that's how just about everyone who picks up a weight loss book feels. I can read you like a book, honey. You have extra pounds to lose, maybe just a few, maybe a lot more than that. You've lost weight before, maybe a few times, maybe a lot of times, but it always comes back. You always regain the pounds you lost, plus a few more. You feel frustrated, angry, and annoyed with yourself that you can't lose the weight for good. You feel like a failure, right? Listen, I get it. I yo-yoed back and forth with a few extra dress sizes myself. I was skinny as a stick into my 20s. But then, I got it into my head that I needed some curves to catch men's eyes. This is something a lot of women of color are used to hearing, even today, when we should all know better. Get some meat on your bones, my family told me. You look like a little girl, not a woman. So when I was in my mid-20s, even though I was a nutritionist practicing in hospitals and nursing homes with a head full of knowledge about what a healthy diet should be, I began what I now think of as a fool's diet. Yes, I actually began intentionally overeating and basically doing the opposite of what I knew was best for my health, eating giant portions, filling up before bedtime, having big desserts, and in no time at all, I got the curves I was looking for. About 30 pounds worth in all. Friends and family congratulated me left and right. But after a couple years, I realized I just didn't like the way all that weight felt and looked on me. So I decided to lose the extra pounds that I was dragging around. I stopped shoveling food onto my plate. Stopped eating steak and cheese subs big enough for three people, and started following more of the dietary advice I was delivering to my patients at work every day. I also started working out zealously with a personal trainer. Before I knew it, the weight came off. Success! Hey, that wasn't so hard. Up and down. Unfortunately, the story doesn't end there. As my zeal for exercise fizzled, my weight ballooned back up. I gained those pounds back. Then I lost them again. And I gained them back again. You know how this story goes, I'm sure. This is your story, too. It's a story that plays out again and again. And the plot line is always the same. We lose weight and we feel good. Then we gain it back, and we feel bad. And throughout it all, we feel like failures because we can't keep the darn weight off. Our closets are sectioned off into thin clothes, medium clothes, and fat clothes. I bounced back and forth from one dress size to another and still another so many times I could have opened a clothing store for women of at least three different sizes. Finally, thank God, I figured things out and lost the weight for good. Yes, you guessed it. I lost that final 15 and kept it off for good. How did I do it? Not by starving myself or following ridiculous fad diets that eliminate entire food groups. Nor did I do it by pledging my soul to an extreme fitness program that required hours and hours in the gym each week, like you. I wanted a final solution. I wanted to lose weight for the last time and not gain it back. I was tired of feeling like a constant failure. And I'm sure you are too. That's why I created the F15 plan. It's designed to help you get back to the weight at which you feel your best, most comfortable, and happiest. Not only will my plan change how your body looks, but it will also alter the way you feel about yourself. Together, we'll banish the word failure from your vocabulary. I will help you lose all the weight you need to lose and keep it off for good. Why 15? I call my plan the Final 15 because I know how overwhelming weight loss and diet change can be. No matter how much weight you have to lose, whether it's 10 pounds or 100 pounds, you're far more likely to succeed if you don't feel overwhelmed by your goal. I'm not saying you shouldn't try to lose a lot of weight. if you're 50, 75, or even 100 pounds overweight. I am totally with you on your desire to drop those extra pounds. But you don't have to do it all at once. As the old saying goes, a journey of 1,000 miles starts with a single step. And losing a big amount of weight starts with a really reasonable goal. Losing 15 pounds. With the F15 plan, I'll help you lose the first 15 pounds, the final 15 pounds, and any number of pounds in the middle. And I'll show you how to keep the last 15 pounds off for good so you'll never have to lose it again. Wouldn't that be a blessing? I also make weight loss easier by breaking down my diet plan into 15-day phases. I don't ask you to count calories, carbs, fat grams, or any of that other nonsense. Instead, keeping it simple, I recommend 15 daily servings of right-sized portions of healthy foods, and I make it easier to create a worthwhile exercise habit by giving you 15-minute workouts. When it comes to weight loss, I've learned another really important lesson. The easier the plan is to follow, the more likely you are to succeed. That's why I've designed the F15 plan with simplicity in mind. I know how busy you are and what your life looks like. You're a parent, helping your kids with homework and driving them all over town for sports, play dates, and educational enrichment. You're a business owner with deadlines to meet and staff to supervise. You're a student, working hard to get an A in every class while working nights and weekends to pay tuition bills. You're an office worker whose 9-to-5 work spills over into nights and weekends. You're a shift worker trying to juggle your job and the needs of your family. You're a teacher, a nurse, a daycare provider, a store clerk. Maybe you're single, looking for that perfect partner, or maybe you've been married for decades. No matter what you do, who you are, or which responsibilities keep you awake at night, I get it. You're busy, you're stressed, you're constantly on the run, and you don't have time to devote hours a day to your weight loss plan. That's why simplicity is the name of the game in the F15 plan. It takes the realities of your life into account, providing an easy-to-follow plan that will fit beautifully into your life. What you're up against. Believe me, I get it. You've worked out, cut calories, and deprived yourself all in hopes of getting rid of the stubborn pounds that have plagued you. Maybe you wanted to drop the baby weight, but the belly bulge still lingers. Or maybe you're a hot guy. I see you. And you know it. But the extra weight you've worked so hard to drop won't, well, budge. Stubborn. I know. I feel your pain. You are not alone. 2/3 of American adults are overweight or obese, and 1/3 of American children are overweight or obese. Let's face it. The fact that in at least 12 states in the United States, 30% of the population is considered obese speaks volumes about the epidemic we face as a country. But don't let these numbers scare you. I've worked with thousands of people who have managed to lose weight and keep it off. It's not as hard as you think. All you need are strategies that work, along with a commitment to do what it takes. I have the strategies, you have the desire. Together, we can beat the numbers. An abundance of energy. In addition to fitting into your busy life, the F15 plan does something else amazing. It actually increases your energy levels so that you'll be better able to handle your life challenges. My clients are amazed at how energetic they feel when they start following the F15 plan. Within days, they feel less tired, less stressed, more invigorated, and more excited about life. This happens for several reasons. Energy-boosting foods. The F15 plan includes an array of foods that infuse you with energy, packed with vitamins, minerals, antioxidants, and other energy-fueling nutrients, F15 foods give your body everything it needs to function at its best. Energy-boosting fitness routines. We all need exercise, but too much activity or the wrong kind of fitness routines can wear you out. Instead, a smart exercise strategy like the one in the F15 plan can get you off the couch, build up your fitness level gradually, and give you energy while burning calories and building muscle. I don't ask you to do too much too soon. I've seen plenty of people ramp up their exercise commitment too fast, only to give it up within days because they feel exhausted and sore. Stick with me, and you'll get all the benefits of fitness, including daily bursts of energy, without the downsides that over-the-top fitness fads can have. Energy-boosting lifestyle choices. One of the things I'm going to talk to you about in this book is getting enough sleep, 7 to 8 hours a night for most people. Adequate sleep is crucial for weight loss because it allows appetite-related hormones to do their jobs and help with weight loss rather than hinder it. And sleep gives you extra energy. When you get enough sleep and feel well-rested, you have the energy you need to make smart choices throughout your day. Plus, having more energy makes it possible to have an active and fulfilling love life. Energy-boosting thought strategies. Having the right mindset helps tremendously with weight loss. If you're not sure whether or not you believe that, look back at the last time you felt angry, irritated, or annoyed, and think about what kinds of foods you chose to put in your mouth while you were experiencing those feelings. Lots of fat, sugar, and salt. Am I right? I'm not promising to make your life a bed of roses or to take away all of the stresses that cause difficult emotions, but I will give you this. Thought strategies that can energize your mind and help you to restructure food-related thinking patterns that cause you stress and contribute to poor choices. It's amazing. Practicing a few simple relaxation strategies can help you feel more energetic throughout the day and help you focus on making choices that support rather than detract from your goals. Once you get into the swing of the F15 plan, you'll start feeling better than you have in a long time, perhaps in years. Combine this with the happiness you'll feel when the pounds start to come off, and believe me, life will be great. Size matters. Now that you understand what I had in mind when I designed the F15 plan, let's talk about size. Serving size, that is. There are two main problems with the standard American diet: what we eat, and how much we eat. We'll talk about what's included in the F15 plan later, but first, let's spend a little time on how much we eat. Over the past few decades, average portion sizes in the United States have grown significantly. This is especially true in restaurants, where portion sizes have doubled or tripled in the past 20 years. When restaurants supersize their meals, it doesn't just make us eat too much when we're out to lunch or dinner. It actually changes the way we think about portion sizes, setting up a new normal in our brains. With these mammoth portions in mind, we serve ourselves extra at home, too. Everything is bigger these days. Bagels have doubled in size. Cheeseburgers come with two or even three thick patties instead of one thin one. Fries are served in shovel-sized containers, and soda cups are as big as buckets. Single-serving bags of potato chips are nearly three times bigger than they used to be. According to one analysis, this portion distortion can contribute to as much as 500,000 extra calories to your diet in just 1 year. No wonder so many Americans are overweight. Even when we choose the healthiest foods, our serving sizes can be too big. Healthy snacks such as guacamole, hummus, and nuts contain lots of fantastic, healthful nutrients. But if you aren't careful, you can eat too much. What looks like a single serving of nuts to the untrained eye, for example, could contain 300 or 400 calories, giving a snack as many calories as, or more calories than, a meal. For all of these reasons, one of the most important parts of the F-15 plan is to focus on serving sizes. I'll show you what serving sizes for various foods should be. If you're accustomed to oversized meals, these portions may seem a little small, but the truth is, they're the serving sizes that we all should be eating. To make it easier for you, I'll also provide visual guides to estimate portion sizes. When a serving size is simple, a medium apple, for example, it's easy to grab a single serving without thinking too much about it. But with things like nuts, meat, and other foods, having a visual guide can help. If you like to measure and weigh, that's fine. But remember, I want things to be easy for you. And if you have to look around for measuring spoons, measuring cups, or a kitchen scale every time you're having something to eat, I consider that a roadblock that should be removed. F-15 self-assessment test. Where are you now? In this book, you'll learn many things about the dietary choices that can lead to weight loss success. In fact, by the time you finish this book, you'll be something of an expert on how to go from intention, I want to lose weight, to achievement, I lost 15 pounds and feel fantastic. To help you take stock of where you are now, spend a few minutes answering the following questions. Then, hang on to the answers because we'll be addressing each of these questions later in the book. Number one, do you skip breakfast as a rule? Number two, if you do eat breakfast, is it filled with bread, potatoes, bacon or sausage, waffles, and pancakes? Number three, do you eat when you're not hungry? Number four, do you know when you're full? Number five, if you eat at fast food restaurants, do you opt for the double or triple burger with large fries and a soda? Number six, do you snack on nuts or nut butter out of the jar or can?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.